What's up, guys? Today I got another Paragon mod to show ya. This time, there is a support Paragon pack. So that includes the Banana Farm, Smactory, Village, and Engineer. Thanks to Depleted Nova for creating it. However, I'm only going to do the Smactory for now. I'm going to check out the rest in another video. Right now, I just want to put my full focus on that Smactory. So yeah, let's check it out. Let's go for all three of the Smactory pads. And let's see what Depleted Nova has for us in store. So the upgrade is called Landmine Overseer. Description, don't tread on me. Yeah, that sure tells us a lot about what it's gonna do. Let's just buy it. 486k. I should know that I also have another mod enabled. It's called Instant Degree, if you haven't seen it in another video already. Basically, it allows you to set the degree of the Paragon. So I don't have to, you know, farm for pops. Right now, I can set degree 1, and that's what we're going to do. Just going to do a degree 1 run on hard mode logs. See how long that can survive, and then we'll do a degree 100. You know the drill, if you have been here already. Anyways, let's see what it does. Basically, it throws out constant spikes all over the map, kind of like a spike storm, but, well, very scattered. And the usual supermines and all that. I assume the bottom path incorporation is basically the fact that these spikes stay on the track for a very long time. It seems like these spike storm spikes don't stay permanently though. Seems to disappear about the same amount of time as like, you know, a normal spike storm ability. But it's the supermines I'm looking at, and I would assume that lasts a long time, because otherwise, yeah, it would just be a top and middle path Smactory showcase, which I don't think is the case. So the normal perma spike lasts about 300 seconds or 5 minutes. I don't think it's been 5 minutes in the game so far though, and you can already see that the mines are timing out. So why do I feel like that this, you know, duration isn't really quote-unquote permanent? Alternatively, perma-spikes can time out at 3 rounds max, if, you know, 300 seconds hasn't elapsed. Which is normally the case, if you kill things, you know, super quickly. But normally what that does is basically when the round starts, all those mines from that, you know, 3 rounds before will all explode at the same time. Which doesn't seem like it's happening right now, because you see, again, it's a periodic explosion. So I'm not exactly sure what is up with this. But either way, we can see that the early 100s are no problem. I mean, no problem with the supermine, so no reason that the Paragon upgrade should struggle at all. So we're just going to fast forward here. Again, this is also a mod, in case you're wondering how we get this fast speed thing. Very helpful for challenges like this. So one thing to know about this Paragon mod is that, just like the real Paragons, there is no ability. You may have seen me check out another mod by another creator. That one included abilities. But yeah, this one doesn't. Just thought I'd make a little disclaimer. Low-key, I do think, again, having abilities for Paragons would be pretty fun. But I feel like what NK designed with these Paragons is, like, meant to be easy to use. Which makes sense given, you know, how much of a casual player base there is in this game. You don't want them having to, you know, constantly time abilities very well in order to maximize a tower's potential. A lot of people just want to plop it down and watch it wreck shit, which we're basically doing right now. I mean, I guess you can say the same with other things like temples where there's no abilities, you just watch and see it. But with that, again, you can buff those towers, so technically, there is some upkeep you need to do in terms of milking it to its maximum potential round. Anyways, going on to 140 here, let's see how much you can do. First off, let me just see how much damage the spikes do, like the spike storm spikes. It seems to be very little. It seems like a majority of damage is just from the storm mine itself. Like, just watch as it plows through all the mines, and I guess it does a decent amount of damage, but kind of expect a little bit more. I know it's degree 1, and the price is pretty low. Maybe my expectations have been altered by the fact that Ninja Paragon's pretty darn good. Again, that is more expensive than this one, though. 486k on hard mode for this one, and it seems like we could die at any time now, so I think we're going to beat this, though. Well, we're going to beat the bad, but I don't think we're going to beat the ZMGs. For that, I don't know what I can do with the Spike Factor, because, well, there's no ability I can use to change anything. No targeting also. So yeah, I don't think there's really much I can improve on. RNG is not really a thing, because all the mines, you know, deploy in this tiny race over here. So 140 may very well be the end for the landmine overseer. This run seems worse, so maybe RNG is a thing. But we got RNG in the wrong direction. I'm gonna keep trying a few more times, but if I don't see any progress, then we are out, and we're gonna see it. The Greet a Hundo. It seems like every subsequent run is getting worse. I think how it works is that when you press retry last round, the RNG quote unquote is the same. But what if I try doing this? Retry last round, going back home, and then pressing continue here. That may change the how this run goes. Let's just see. Or is it the same? No, it seems like the same. I don't know why the first run was the best, but it looks like 140 is the end. Even with that first run, it wasn't really particularly close with the ZMGs. But yeah, now we're gonna restart and we're going to set the degree to 100 and see where that ends up with. So yeah, as I was saying earlier about the fact that this Paragon has no abilities, I guess that makes it more realistic because again, it sounds like at this point, because the first three that NK released have no abilities, it seems like it's gonna be a common trend that they're just gonna be plop them down and that's all you can do with it. Anyways, let me just see how fast this thing... Yeah, this definitely shoots a lot faster. Much faster spikes. Much more super mines in the middle here. And so far I'm looking at when they explode. Because I want to see how the perma spike is incorporated. And yeah, they're exploding now. That definitely was not 5 minutes. So I don't know if the creator forgot that Bonapath spike existed. But that definitely doesn't look like perma spike mines to me. Or perma spike storm spikes. Oh, I think what I do know though is that the Bonapath is incorporated, just not perma spike. Because generally, spike mines, they all explode at the end of the round, but this looks like it carries over a few rounds. It's just a timeout is much sooner. So that might be why I died on 140 when I pressed retry last round, because the game didn't save the super mine spikes. So I restarted with less spikes, and that is why I did worse every round after. So it sounds like I only have one shot, one opportunity to, well, beat this. If I die to a round, and I retry last round, it's pretty much game over, if I have to assume. Anyways, back on the topic of Paragons and abilities, I got sidetracked twice, I think, at this point. What I wanted to say was that because this is, I guess, fairly realistic, aside from the fact that it doesn't last as long as I would expect it to, I think it'd be very fun to, well, come back to this video in a few months or a few years when they finally release Paragon and, well, see how it matches up to the accuracy of this mod. That is, of course, assuming that, you know, Spike Factory isn't next. I'm not sure what is next. If I do assume, it'd probably be a military because, well, they went two primaries, they went one magic. It'd feel weird to do another magic and then just skip, keep military forever alone. I feel that makes sense for no support Paragons to be added for quite a while because there's only four of them and, well, I actually kind of wonder how Village and Banana Farm will work. How will the degrees work for that one? Because, well, you can't really farm Pops with Banana Farms. Nor can you do it with a Village. Well, you could, but asking someone to get 16.2 million Pops with a Primary XP piece is going to be a tall task. I think they would... I assume they would probably have to rework the formula, of course. I think right now the formula is going to be the same for pretty much every tower here. Actually, I'm not sure about Ice and Glue. If you recall for those mods, those were pretty rough to get popped on. So I reckon either they won't plan on doing an Ice or Paragon or Glue Paragon mod for a while, or a real one, sorry. But they're probably, if they do add it, they're probably going to rework the formula. Again, I doubt that's going to come anytime soon. It seems like looking at one Paragon every update, and it seems like updates nowadays are getting a little bit slower and slower. Like, instead of, like, small updates, but fairly frequent, like, once a month, they're opting for 2+ months without an update, but giving some much-needed massive content instead, which is good. I am honestly fine with either way, but I'm cool with waiting 2+ months if every update has, well, a lot of content to look at. So if you look at it that way, yeah, to get all Paragons in the game, well, it certainly take quite a few years, and I certainly wonder how it's going to work for battles. I wonder if they're even going to incorporate any of the current Paragons into battles. Battles 2, I mean. If I had to guess, probably not, because, well, again, if you didn't see the announcement for it, it looks like late game isn't slated on the table because all the rounds end at 50. So it sounds like there's no use of Paragons anyways, until they add a casual game mode, or a mode where you can reasonably afford the most expensive towers. Anyways, we just breezed through round 140. I don't think it was even close, although I wasn't really paying attention. But it's easy to see right here, the bad tier, just absolutely getting annihilated. So yeah, again, no surprise that degree 100 is degrees more powerful than degree 1. Just a matter of how long it's gonna survive now. Again, gotta be careful, gotta watch carefully for when it starts struggling. Cause then, if I have to reach our last round, then that's pretty much the end of me. Although granted, again, I said that you can't really micro. So this pretty much is a hands-off experience for me. I'm just commentating and staring at the screen. No hands on the keyboard. They're busy doing something else. So, status update. It seems like nothing is still getting past that first line of spikes. Like, even bads at round 174, they just hit here and die. So with that, it looks like we're going to surpass a degree 100 Boomerang Paragon and Dark Paragon, which is quite impressive because I think this mod has been bounced a few times. This mod actually got released quite a while ago, but it wasn't able to cover it until now, just because the update was in the way, so I decided to look at that first before I actually decide to go back to mods. But yeah, this mod is basically designed with realism in mind, in terms of the power. It's definitely more efficient than a Boomerang Paragon, that's for sure, if we're talking about soloing. Seems like there's some actual potential to get to around 200 here, and I'm not kidding. It is looking that strong. Mid round 180s update, still nothing really getting past bend 1 here. Again, that's pretty crazy to me, that the difference between degree 1 and degree 100 in this one is much better than the current Paragons, and even the Paragon mod that I saw in the other mod pack. Again, I'm trying to assume that the degree curve, damage curve, is the same with this one, but why do I feel like it's different? Or if it is the same, then what makes this thing so much better than degree 1? I guess that's what I'm wondering. I wonder if actually the lifespan is longer with this one than degree 1. It doesn't look like it, at least for the super mines. But maybe the spike storm spikes stay a little longer. I highly doubt it though. It just seems to be raw power. This thing just blows number 1 out of the water. Near round 200 update. It seems like we're starting to struggle, or rather, this is the first round that Balloons got halfway mark. And that actually spells bad news for round 200, because that just got rid of a lot of spikes that I think we're going to carry over to 200. And I don't know how long it lasts in terms of rounds. I just know in terms of time, I think those spikes still would have been alive at that point. Or maybe not, this round's pretty long. Yeah, we're definitely not having any spikes saved up for 200. Definitely looks like we're beating 199 though. Let's see how much we can stall it out. No, we can't. Wow. We have like 10 spikes set up pre-200. So let's watch here. Already 20%, that looks pretty good. 40%. 60. Wait, how is this so good? It's definitely the carpet of spikes damage, I'm pretty sure. That's what's helping us win. Because I thought we were definitely a dead duck at, 200. Like, how is 199, 198 a problem if this round isn't? Weird. Well, let's just see how long it lasts now. It definitely seems like in combination with other balloons, then the 4-5 bats could get pretty far. But that's just my guess. That would certainly be wild, wouldn't it? This mod beating out the Ninja Paragon for degree 100, which got to 211, yet it failed miserably compared to degree 1 Ninja, about 20 rounds less. Granted, it looks like right now we're nearing the end. Let's see how these four bads are. I reckon they're slow enough that we'll build enough spikes at the back, so that might be why bads are easy. They don't have other balloons like getting rid of the spikes in the way. I think that makes perfect sense for why we were dying those other rounds, but not 200. Guess they underestimated the spike storm damage for this guy here. Again, 204, no biggie. This round's definitely getting furthest so far. That 4-5 bad, second last bend. Again, those other balloons are just clearing the way. The balloons are smarter, guys. They know how to counter this spike factor here. Only a matter of time at this point. Oh man, this round looks gnarly. Four space bands and a bunch of ZMGs in the way to get rid of the spike mines for me. Yeah, there's just this fortified bad here, guys. Although I think we'll have enough in the tank, albeit barely. Yeah, first balloons that got to the last bend. Just a few more rounds for it to pass Ninja. I think you can do it. There's certainly a good reason Ninja did this round, because there's a lot of bads, but it looks like, no, it's easier than 209. I think we're gonna have it. And indeed we are. There we have it, guys. This Paragon is insane at degree 100 for God knows why. But we're gonna savor it. Oh, this round's really bad. Or really nasty. Can we do it? There's four ZMGs left. And I think they have a chance to get through. Oh, they're getting really close. Holy crap. Holy crap, those spikes. Words can't describe how close that run was. Alright, this round looks like trouble. There's one more fortify bad. Two more ZMGs. Slow down. Oh, it's over. Ah. 217, ladies and gents. So that is it for the degree 100 spike factor paragon. Pretty nutty if you ask me. A very cursed 666 million pops. What are the chances? But yeah, I hope you enjoyed this paragon mod showcase. There's certainly more on the way. Then the creator even said that there's going to be magic paragon soon, but we'll have to wait on that. Thank you for watching. If you liked, then why don't you press that like button? It exists for a reason. Check out the mod playlist if you missed out on any of the other modded videos, and I'll see you guys in the next video.